Chapter 1, Intro.
Good morning!
Morning!
Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're diving into an electrifying topic in home automation, fault-free switching. What is it? Why should you care? And how can you use it effectively in Home Assistant? Stick around and I promise, by the end of this video, you'll be switching things on and off like a true home automation wizard.
Chapter 2, Disclaimer.
Just a quick note before we get to it. This video is not sponsored by AliExpress or anyone else for that matter. Yep, no free gadgets here. Everything you see in this video was bought with my own money, so you can trust that my opinions are completely honest and unbiased. If a device is great, I'll tell you. If it's garbage, I'll definitely tell you. Now let's get it started.
Let's get it started. Ha! Let's get it started in here.
Chapter 3. What is a fault-free switching?
Fault-free switching, also known as dry contact switching, allows a relay or switch to control a circuit without directly supplying power. Instead, they use an external power source. This is particularly useful for controlling boilers, garage doors, ventilation and alarm systems, and other low-voltage devices. Unlike traditional relays, a volt-free relay acts like a matchmaker for electricity, letting different voltage systems communicate safely without the risk of an electrifying breakup.
Chapter 4. Do you need a volt-free switch?
The simplest answer is, I don't know. Maybe? Ask yourself, do I have any volt-free circuits in my home? Do I own a device that depends on a volt-free circuit? Do I want to control this device like a true smart home master? If you answered yes to all of the above, congratulations. This video is for you. If you answered no.
No! God, please, no! No! No!
Well, stick around anyway, because you never know when volt-free switching might come in handy. I have a few volt-free circuits in my home, but today, I'll focus on one that controls the booster for my bathroom extractor fan. Since this booster switch is part of a volt-free circuit, I can't just slap in a regular Zigbee switch module. Those need to be powered by the circuit they control. Honestly, this was one of my biggest smart home challenges, finding a solution that lets me control the booster of my bathroom extractors without upgrading my entire ventilation system. Here's my volt-free circuit, proudly displaying a whopping 7.8 millivolts. Truly an electrifying amount of nothing.
Chapter 5. Miracle or mistake?
After an intense search session and resisting the urge to buy an RGB toaster along the way, I finally found the solution to my volt-free switching dilemma, a volt-free Zigbee smart switch from AliExpress. Price? A mind-blowing £5.54 with free shipping. That's cheaper than a fancy coffee, and unlike that overpriced latte, this switch won't disappear in 5 minutes, hopefully. But the real question is this a smart home hero or just another cheap gadget destined to collect dust in my ever-growing pile of great ideas gone wrong? Let's see if this bargain is a blessing or a blunder. What did I receive? Well, let's just say the unboxing experience was minimalistic. Zigbee 7 to 32 volt self-locking smart switch module, the star of the show. Quick start guide, in English and Chinese, with font size so small it could only be read with a magnifying glass and diagrams that make IKEA manuals look detailed. Nothing else. No cables. No stickers. Not even a tiny screwdriver to immediately lose. Just raw unfiltered AliExpress efficiency. Now let's have a quick look at the switch itself. This little volt-free switch module has two power supply options. 5 volts USB power, featuring a micro USB port, because apparently, USB-C was too fancy. AC-DC 7 to 32 volts, for those who like their voltage with a side of variety. One input for the volt-free circuit you want to control. A manual switch slash pairing button. A mode switch button. It looks pretty simple. I wonder if setting it up will be just as easy, or if I've just signed up for an unexpected DIY nightmare.
Chapter 6. Setup.
Let's get this Zigbee volt-free switch module up and running in Home Assistant. This process is so easy, you could probably do it in your sleep, but please stay awake, because electrical safety is still a thing. Step 1. Pair the switch. Time to introduce this new recruit to the Zigbee network. Put your Zigbee gateway into pairing mode. If you're using Zigbee 2 MQTT like me, Just click Permit Join in the web interface. Power on the Volt-Free switch. I plan to use USB power, and luckily, I found a USB to micro USB cable in my drawer, a rare win in the world of cable chaos. Once powered, the switch should enter pairing mode automatically. If it doesn't, just press and hold the pairing button until it starts blinking like a desperate Wi-Fi signal in a basement. Be patient. Give it a moment. Zigbee devices sometimes take their sweet time to show up in Home Assistant. But once it pops up in your device list, congratulations. Your switch is officially part of the smart home family. Step 2. Name your new gadget. A good name means you won't spend the next 5 years wondering what Switch 27 actually controls. Click Rename Device in your Zigbee 2 MQTT interface and give your new gadget a proper name that actually tells you what it is and where it lives. For example, I named mine SWVF Utility R Booster. SW, a shortcut for Switch, because we're keeping it efficient. VF, a shortcut for Volt Free, because it is. Utility R, because it's installed in the utility room where my ventilation unit is located. Booster, because it boosts the airflow in my bathrooms. Before you click Rename Device, make sure to enable Update Home Assistant Entity ID so the new name updates everywhere in your smart home setup. Need help naming your devices? Check out my video, The Perfect Naming Conventions: Simplify Your Smart Home. Click the pop-up in the top right corner now or find the link in the description. Step 3. Fine-tune the settings. A smart home should be organized, unlike my junk drawer, which contains at least 5 old remotes and a mystery key I'm too afraid to throw away. Click on your new device in the Zigbee 2 MQTT interface. In the About tab, you can add a description. This is optional but could be very useful in the future. I added Volt-Free Switch in Utility Room, Extractor Booster. Switch to the Settings Specific tab and set state action to true because you want to know the actual state of your switch. Go to the Expose tab and set power on behavior. Since I use automations and existing physical switches to control the booster, I set mine to off. I don't need it turning on like a haunted appliance after a power outage. That's it. Zigbee 2 MQTT setup is done. Step 4. Make it feel at home. Now let's integrate it properly into Home Assistant. Go to Settings. Click Devices and Services. Then switch to the Devices tab. Find your new switch and click on it. Tap the pencil icon to edit. Assign it to a room, utility room, garage, supervillain HQ. Hey, world domination starts with good organization. Add labels if you want to keep things tidy or just confuse future you less. Click Update and you're done. Your Zigbee Volt-Free switch is now paired, named, and fully set up. But before we celebrate, there's one final question, or rather two. Does it actually work? And if so, how well does it perform?
Chapter 7, Testing.
Time to find out just how reliable this fine piece of Chinese engineering really is. The switch is already powered up, so now it just needs to be connected to the circuit it's supposed to control. For the sake of this video, and totally not because I didn't feel like messing with my ventilation system just yet, I'm using an old set of solar-powered lights instead, to make sure the circuit is open, and to justify my totally professional wiring skills, I had to cut the wire. Don't worry, it had a good life. Now I can connect the lights to the Volt-Free switch. Okay, lights are hooked up. Time for the moment of truth. Press the manual switch button a few times to open and close the circuit. Does it work? Mine does. Hopefully yours does too. If not, have you tried turning it off and on again? Now, let's see if we can control it from Home Assistant. Open your Volt-Free switch from the devices list or directly from the Zigbee 2 MQTT page and toggle it a few times. And boom, works like a charm. How about yours? Please say it does.
Chapter 8, The Verdict.
So was this a genius purchase or a regrettable impulse buy? Turns out, it's a small miracle. This Zigbee switch is simple, highly reliable, and ridiculously cheap. Sure, it doesn't come with fancy packaging or even a USB cable, but who needs those, right? It works flawlessly with Home Assistant and does exactly what I need. Would I buy it again?
Abso-fucking-lutely.
Would I trust it with mission-critical tasks? Not sure yet. But for non-essential automation, it's perfect. That said, the exact same model has been powering my bathroom extractor fans for over a year without a single issue, so maybe this little gadget deserves more credit. Moral of the story: sometimes the cheapest solution is actually the best one.
Chapter 9. Thank you.
Hey, you made it to the end. Thanks for watching, reading, or casually skimming while pretending to work. If you enjoyed this, please like, subscribe, and drop a comment. It really helps. Want to support the channel? Buy me a coffee, because smart home tinkering runs on caffeine. Join my Patreon, or use PayPal to chip in. Any form of support makes me feel special. All links are in the description. See you in the next one. Happy vol-free switching!